because I accidentally started to game over, but I did collect all the human hair, I think, so I did, yeah. And the music turned off by itself, I think, anyway, so now you can see the bits.
They're so happy. There aren't any pictures of the bad times. These are in the basement. She only takes them out when Daddy's living with us. You know, in stories where the little girl is really a princess and her parents aren't really her parents? Does she still get to see them?
Yeah, most times, I think. Then again, in most fairy tales, the parents are dead or something. It's like Batman, for some reason. Don't know, that's where I get the inspiration from. Collect everything? What did I do?
No. Oh, it's yeah. An eviction notice! Daddy says he's gonna pay all the bills when the circus is a big hit. Come on, I want to go find Vincenzo.
See if he's got big dosh to pay it with. I make sure I'm not missing anything. Oh, so I can collect it, cool. Can view it myself.
I don't think they'll hold you. You'll have to go through shadows.
That's not very safe. Why am I letting you do that? And this shadow dash is a bit weird because sometimes it, like, gets me out of the shadow thing. Oh yeah. Okay, I'm going this way. I was like, can I not go this way? I didn't get perfect on the first go, by the way. It's just because I know which order to do it in, which is space, then do the dash. So this is where I turn the camera up, because, jeez, there's so many gaps to fall through.
Hey, Vincenzo. Ready for our big night? People are really excited.
You're gonna have to give them their money back.
What? We're sold out.
You haven't paid me.
I got the money. We're selling out. You'll have it before the show.
Even if you do, I can't perform here. Your circus is a disaster.
It's coming together.
Your puppet show about the princess is missing the princess. You've lost your hot air balloon, and where did you get that pirate ship? It is a broken down piece of junk.
Come on, Vincenzo. Yeah. It's opening day. There's always a few wrinkles to iron out. Look, I'll get it all fixed. No problem. Consider it done.
All right. But don't think that I will be some sort of shiny bauble that lures people into your scrapyard.
He's so mean.
I'll get it fixed, I promise. Or I'm a dead man.
I'm worried about Daddy. He always says it's okay, but those gangsters really hurt him. We have to fix the circus, so Daddy will be safe. Come on, it's this way.
Yeah, I am sending that even there. Always catch it. There was this collectible I found at the house, which I'm not really too sure on some bit. Wait, can I? No, I can't zoom in. But yeah, he's pressed out some bits, and it's not really the best way to press out bits, so you can still read it. And it makes you think, what age is it acceptable to not have imaginary friends anymore? And if it's one of those games where they think it's mentally disturbed if they have imaginary friends at a certain age. Basically, Alice in Wonderland. And they call it an active imagination. And there is this part down here where he says he talked to her, or had a good talking to her. Which I'm not too sure if, I don't know, it's just the way he's worded it is making it sound a little bit like he's abused her. Well, shit, basically. Look how pretty this is outside. Damn, stars. I gotta have stars. And this bit is a little bit weird because when I just randomly walked out, it made me fall. So, I'm not too sure how much I can walk around this bit. Especially with some bits. Glitching in and out. I'm guessing they're supposed to do that because it's basically game you're not really supposed to go to, it's off limits or something like that. Yeah, let's go down here. I think that's where it's supposed to go.
Look, there's the balloon. It got snagged so they can't pull it down. But nobody can get up there to untangle it.
Except for me.
I bet somebody didn't pay attention when he was tying it down. A carousel! I think I can turn it on. I think we just need...
Oh, I just still need one more. Sorry, I was interrupting you. Little girl, darling. Don't know what I call you, but...
I think I can turn this on now. I think you're gonna need to get that beacon working.
Yeah, I do, by the looks of things. I should be able to get onto the spirits.
Sorry.
It's fine, I'm just gonna jump on your head.
Giddy up, Horsey!
Yee-haw! Woo! It's actually a bit smoother. Oh. I was gonna say it's a bit smoother than it was before, where I just couldn't get through anything. I kept shifting in and out by itself. Yeah, still doing that.
Woohoo!
It's fine! Stop apologizing. I'm just jumping on your head. There's nothing wrong with that. What? How?
Are you okay up there?
Yeah,
you need
I'm fine.
Any help? Here, jump on
this!
What
are you doing? I mean, thank you for that.
I think you're gonna need to get that beacon working.
Yeah, I know, that's what I'm trying to do, sweetie.
Okay, now you can get up to the roof and untangle Daddy's balloon.
Oh yeah, I can, that's cool. You know, on those bits where it takes me a while to figure out things, I wonder if she's just sitting there, like, come on, Acrobat. You've been through this before, you know what to do, come on. Just waiting here patiently. I wonder if she's just doing that while sitting there waiting for me to do these things. I probably should have just jumped in there to start up. Might have done something. Nope. That's helpful. Okay, back up here. I actually had to go back up this way instead of the other way I was playing. So that just wasn't working. Okay, I'm up here. I just jumped onto this. Right, see, I'm hovering, but whatever. Why not just go jumping around or whatnot? Oh, yeah, I did this one. Okay. Go on this bit, I'm guessing. Oh. What next? Isn't it basically you to me? And it's, I swear to God, if you fell, just wouldn't be happy. No. Please, thank you. I don't know what that was. Apparently it's the cycle battle. Oh, here's the boon. I just had to go around now on the roofs.
Yay! You did it! Okay! Hop in!
Hop in the boon.
That was amazing! I wish I could do that. Would you teach me someday?
Sure, I've got a few things to teach you on my list, apparently. I hope there wasn't anything I left out on there. I came down, I didn't notice. I'm gonna do that. Okay, I got up. Damn, I had to do that a few times. I do not support any of that. That's why I jumped upon your heads. Oh, I just need to back in and mud. So pretty. I don't even know if I'm supposed to go this way or not. Amazing flying pigs. What? Why can I not play any of these? It shouldn't be too bad if he's still got all the usual things that what a soul, but it's, oh, what is this?
Oh, look at that! This looks amazing!
It does.
The gangway is stuck up there. How do we get on board?
I don't know. I need to do my jumping skills, I'm guessing. needs maintenance or it will jam. Put Dee Dee on the boat. I don't know if the boat is safe. I can pick it up. Why didn't you tell me this yacht's evil? I saw another box in that evil. Oh, you can shift it. Cool. Oh, so I just had to jump out. Okay. Does that do anything for you? Yeah, that does that.
Captain on the deck. Alas, there, first mate. Anchors away. Let's heave ho and hoist the mainsail.
What is this thing for? What does this do? Am I being really stupid or something? What's this? Oh no. I'm guessing I need to put the box on it, right? So I can't really put the box in it. Oh, there's another one up here. Well, that opens that. That need to do anything for you, girl? Let me put the box on the red one first. I'm not too sure what this does. Just drop it to get in there and do something. Oh damn, I can put a box on this one as well. How many of these are there? There's only one box. How do I... So, I would have to put a box on the other one. And then go to this bit by myself and open it for her. And then find another way for myself to get through. Is that it? Find a way to keep the doors open though. How? Let's see what this does. Oh, cool. I'm not sure how much this helps. Can I not jump up here by myself? You're jumping way higher than it. Your bit is. How? You're not able to jump there yourself. I just remembered there's another box back here which I can now bring up there. I'm saying it's pretty much impossible with just one box. One problem, I can't move this box off. It just won't let me pick it up. I guess I have to restart from the save. Look how pretty this yard screen is though. Beautiful. Come on, dude, you can do better than that. Get me all the way up there. Almost, dude. Bit more. That's it, you got it, but I didn't jump off. Okay, apparently I had to be right on it at the right time, and then it just propels me upwards. I don't even know. I have to do this bit all over again, so that was from the last save. Great. Oh, I just realised I would need that box on there anyway because there's that red bit. That's what it gets rid of. Right. Okay, I'm up here finally. God, it took too long. I'm gonna get to you in there though. If I could. It's so jumpy, honestly. I hate it. What did you... Oh, the other box is up there. Okay. I won't be able to get up without the box. Also, I just realised it does stop moving after a while, so that's why the mechanic is there to move it around again. It's also to get the box out in case you make it stop the box. And just make it fly out. So I just popped from up there and got no scars or anything. I guess that's what an acrobat can do. Out there. It wasn't perfectly put on there when I popped it down, but whatnot. Whatever. Let's get me over to this bit and then put that box on the button and it should be done. Whatever, shift out. There you go. Well done.
Second star on the right and straight on till morning.
Okay then. Oh, and if some of the bits are a bit smaller, more blackness around them, that's because I had to make it even small resolution for it to just run smoothly.
Full speed ahead! All hands on deck! Letting down the hatches!
Well, this isn't safe. Who else is scared for their life? Except for me. Raise your hand. Jeez, jump scares much.
Isn't it supposed to attack us or something?
It just did. Pretty sure. What is this? I don't know. Let's do that. See what it does.
Isn't the ghost supposed to shoot it again?
Well, the cannonball's over there, so... That's really creative, this game. Yeah, I just have to jump off at the last minute. Took a few pros. Open this door first. Or just do that. Whatever works, you know? Shift in. Then just put it on the same bit that the other one was on. Get up here and just... could I just leave it here or...? Not sure, I can't exactly jump in here with it. Okay, so it still picks up even if it's shifted in. Is it? I mean, it's still technically a shadow anyway, is it? Does it still work? Yeah, it does, that's cool. And there we go.
Yeah, take that! Go back where you came from, you big squid! Go find a whale to pick on!
Okay. Didn't I get that human now? I thought I did. Must have forgot it was there. I was up there. Okay, got it now. I just did that thing even though I could come through the door. Supposed to do at this bit, and I can. Nope, that's a cannon. I thought it was a vase at first. Wait, I can go inside it. What? Oh, there's another cannonball down here. That's what you're supposed to pick up. I could put the human hairs in there as well, but I guess that's what we ate to do this first. I mean, I thought I was going to be the cannonball. Gonna do that cannonball somewhere else after them. That's fine. How would I get across though? That's a problem. So I guess you could have dropped it there and then pump it and pick it up again. I guess that also works. How do I? That also works. Put it in there. That's how a cannonball gets scan them.
Take that! Bam!
Jeez,
sick and bite, Gracie! Uh-oh! We didn't break anything, did we?
Now I've got to put the human hairs
in there.
Maybe
we can get out that way.
So if we made it worse than it actually was in the first place, is that what we've done?
Something actually broken. I bet it's just something you forgot to turn on.
Probably. Sorry about that, my brother was going down the stairs. There it is again. Might just be me hearing it.
I bet there's just like one thing he forgot to do, and that's why the whole ride isn't working. It's probably in the control room, or the engine room, or something like that.
It's a good thing I can one pass you, just
come
on,
it's dark out there. How are you gonna climb on shadows if it's dark?
Good question.
Hey, this is that maintenance room I was talking about.
Mine.
I think we can restart the whole ride. Huh. I knew it. I knew it was something simple. I think all we need to do is pull these levers at...
Oh, wow.
Same time.
Okay, what one do I need to pull this one?
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, go!
I already did it a bit sooner, but whatever. Whoa. Kind of looks like Frankenstein.
I think we fixed the whole thing!
Maybe we did. Whoa. That actually looks so cool. I'd be terrified of it as a kid, but it still looks really cool. There's definitely going to be in here. Wonder if it would have mattered what order you did it in. Probably not.
Hey, has anyone seen the princess puppet? We can't really start the story without her.
That sounds like Daddy.
Isn't that it
there? I know she's around here somewhere.
Oh, I'm actually being the prince.
Ah, there she is. Once upon a time, there was a princess who lived in a castle with her father, the king. The king loved her very much because daddies loved their daughters. Unfortunately, the kingdom also had an ogre who was eating travelers because ogres do that.
They do that, yeah.
So, the king did what kings do, and promised that anyone who slew the ogre would get to marry his only daughter, the princess, and become king when he died. The king's lands were very far away, and the ogre was very large, so only one knight showed up. His name was Fred.
Fred.
And he fell immediately in love with the princess. Fred was a brave knight, and he marched off the next morning singing a brave song as loudly as he could.
Does that brave song?
After several days had passed, the princess got to wondering what had happened to her future husband.
What happened?
So she set off into the forest to look for him. The princess tracked Fred's footprints through a strange wilderness full of scary sounds and hidden dangers. Chasms filled with razor-sharp bamboo. Fortunately, she was a very brave princess who loved adventures, just like you. She used her wits to get past unexpected obstacles.
Yeah, I would have to do that.
She came to a wide river filled with snapping crocodiles.
Nope.
Unfortunately, she fell in the water and drowned. Wait, that's not what happened.
Well.
She came to a wide river filled with snapping crocodiles. She couldn't even swim.
She had to do it fast.
So what do you think she did?
She ran on top of their heads.
That's right. It was a magical forest where the plants seemed to know each other. She had to use magic mushrooms to get high, or up.
Damn. He It does make you notice how long the princess is taking. It's a bit odd.
She learned to use some bendy tree branches to fling herself across a patch of deadly sharp bamboo. As the sun was setting, she came to the giant ogre's campsite.
Oh no.
And there, the princess discovered that the ogre had captured Fred and hung him from a tree as a snack. The ogre did not appreciate visitors at all. Even Fred seemed a little embarrassed to see her. But the princess was a woman of action, and she was nimble, and the ogre was clumsy and easy to taunt.
I also fell out.
That's when you make fun of someone. You should never make fun of people, but with ogres, sometimes you have to.
So you have to yearn to cut down the tree with his baseball bat, axe, whatever it is. Finally. Took way too many tries.
And so the princess tricked the ogre and rescued Fred. Fred didn't feel too good about it. He really loved the princess. Fortunately, the king told him about a giant spider that he could slay in order to win the princess's hand. So Fred marched off to the lair of the giant spider, singing a brave song, a little less loudly than before. Wow. After several days had passed, the princess got to wondering what had happened to her future husband. So she went off looking for him again.
Again? Wow. I can't go back.
Fred's footprints led her into a dark and creepy cavern, full of strange dripping sounds, kind of like the basement at school. Her footsteps echoed and echoed until it sounded like someone was following her.
Oh. Okay, do that.
Soon she came to a vast pit filled. Unfortunately, she impaled herself on the bamboo. Wait, that's not what happened. Soon she came to a vast pit filled with vicious, deadly spikes. It was much too big to jump over. But far off, she could hear moaning. She thought it might be Fred. So what do you think she did?
I know.
What?
She used an umbrella.
What?
Like that nanny in that movie.
This is the Middle Ages, honey. Where would she get an umbrella?
Yeah,
I don't know. That's what she used.
I don't think I have an umbrella.
Well, you better find one, because she used an umbrella.
Where am I supposed to get an umbrella?
Do I just shift out and get it? So it doesn't he notice me doing this?
Oh, there we go. So the princess bravely threw herself into the air, slowing her fall using an umbrella. Just like that nanny in the movie.
She floated
down into the cave, deeper and deeper into the cavern.
I have to get the umbrella again.
She thought she could hear Fred moaning, but maybe it was only the wind.
He's cheating on me before he's even got with me. Whoa. So the spider has impaled him. I don't know if I have to look out for the ones on top.
Finally, she landed softly. Right in a spider's web!
Well, do I have to reload it from the save point? I've got so far though. I mean, I'm pretty sure you were supposed to fall in it. There's nowhere else you can go. I can't shift out. Oh, you're supposed to keep
jumping. Fortunately, it was a very old web.
I just had to search Google how to do it. I thought it was a bug.
Unfortunately, the web was the only thing holding up a giant boulder. The princess needed to find somewhere to hide.
Thank you, Kim. Old webs. So go hide here. There we go.
Suddenly, a giant spider jumped out of the shadows and attacked her. She ran and climbed and jumped and climbed, but the giant spider was very good at climbing too. It had 8 legs and the princess only had 2.
Right. Nope.
Unfortunately, the princess remembered how the webs were holding up boulders.
Yeah. Thank you for telling me that. Move out of the way. Come on.
Poor spider.
Finally, she found Fred. He was all wrapped up like a present for the giant spider's girlfriend. He was dreadfully embarrassed about having to be rescued again.
He
really loved the princess. The princess decided he was cute.
That was it.
Fortunately, the king told him about a dragon that he could slay in order to win the princess's hand and stop being so embarrassed. So Fred marched off to the mountaintop of the dragon, singing a brave song.
Don't kill the dragon, come on. You really have to slay a dragon, I don't want to.
After a few days, the princess got to wondering
why her dad kept trying to give her away.
That too. Yeah.
But she was worried about Fred, so she went off to find him.
Again.
The dragon's mountain was cold, and the wind howled at her to turn back. There were rock slides and fiery chasms, but she was very brave and nimble, just like you.
She was pushed.
She wasn't going to be put off by a few deadly dangers.
Make you fall. I do. Hopefully there's not another one. I thought those were counting spikes.
Up and up she climbed. When she got cold, she thought about the hot buttered muffin she would make once she got Fred home.
Do you still like muffins?
I love muffins.
Same.
The princess hoped Fred liked muffins.
Oh well. I guess I'm supposed to wait on this. Oh well. Ow, come on. I'm actually supposed to stay on these. Because there was just another walk. I'm guessing that noise is stopping when another walk's coming. Just sort of remake my way past. You can continue
when the
story
princess
now,
got to the lair of the dragon, she was not very surprised to see Fred hanging from the roof of the dragon's cave. So she taunted the dragon until it roared its fiery breath at her.
Oh. And she was burned alive. Burn it on Fred. He needs no help. How is it not burning Fred? Is he just... what's the word for unburnable? Come on, one more. Come on, get me. Come on, get me. Are you kidding me? Okay, you just restart from here, so I'll have to do those two again.
Finally, burning away the ropes that were tying up Fred.
But somehow not burning Fred.
And so the princess and Fred lived happily ever after. Fred never had to go on another adventure again. And they had hot buttered muffins every morning.
I thought I was going to say
something.
There's
another version of the story where the princess flew off on the dragon's back to have a life full of adventures, but that's for another day.
Yay! Yay, Dawn, you did it!
I did. What was your other name, Dawn? Handy person. Stuff my brooms made of. Get to the circus tent. See how the show went.
Vincenzo came back!
Hey, what do you think, Vincenzo? Did you ever consider trying out for the trapeze?
They're good at what they do, Mr. Fenris. I'll give you that.
I got my balloon back, I got a princess from my puppet theater, and my pirate ship is sailing the bounding main.
So you're a man of your word.
Go ahead, count it. It's all there. Need a hand with your stuff?
My apparatuses are very delicate, and I don't like anyone in my workshop. Provide the audience, Mr. Fenris, and I will provide amazement. Mr. Fenris.
Also egotism.
Why are you organizing this circus? I know who your investors are.
But I promised my wife and daughter I'd clean up my act.
But if I don't pull in the crowds for you, those boys are gonna put you in the river.
Without Cat and Dee Dee, I wouldn't care much if they did.
Ah.
So those crowds better come.
I didn't talk to him. I didn't talk to Vincenzo.
Do you really want to after seeing what kind of person he is? I'm sure he's keeping the show running all, but it's just a bit, shady, I guess. Egotistical. All those words. Yeah, act three. So I'm going to finish this part here because I might as well do each act in each part, whatever. Make sure everyone has enjoyed. I hope you're enjoying the series as I like this game so far. It's very cool. Bye.